Pierre, what do you see as the global trends coming up? So if you look, you're in 85 countries. Clearly different regions of the world have different parts that are growing faster than others. But what are you identifying as the global trends in the aesthetic skincare industry?
There is one trend which we benefit from, obviously, which is personalization. I mean, I think that more and more people are looking for solutions that are suiting their needs. They want to be taken care of as individuals. This is why personalization has developed. Social network has helped personalization as well, that's for sure. But culturally, I mean, personalization is a huge trend that will only develop and increase, not only in beauty, in every aspect of the market. I think that transparency is becoming very, very important. Social responsibility, I mean, everybody's talking about it, but I think now consumers will want proofs, not only greenwashing marketing. So that's again a big, big trend. And I think that's the positive side. Research, discoveries, medical discoveries, and talking about beauty on skin, technology on diagnosis, I mean, it's going to be very exciting in the next years. I
What
mean,
about
if you did research on DNA, it's fascinating.
What about ethnicity? Can you talk a little bit about that? So
About what?
about the role of ethnicity in skincare. So is there much going into the research of how different skin types and ethnicities respond to various skin products?
Yes, I mean by nature, but that's not new. I mean we I mean the industry knows the differences between the skin. I mean the skin structure is exactly the same, but the importance of the layers and the functioning can be slightly different. So that's not new news, and that's known by the industry for a long time, and the industry has adapted that since a long time. I mean, take for instance Asian skin, they tend to have a better seborrheic production, okay, which is a problem for them because aesthetically they don't like to have the T-zone and greasy skin. But the good news is that they have less wrinkles because it's a kind of natural moisturizer, okay. So there are differences, of course, and we know them, and we adapt our treatment and offering like other brands do. So that's not a major, for me, it's not going to be a major change. It's just incremental research, innovation. But this is not, I mean, we are not discovering the differences between ethnical skins. That's not news. And even if you again take Asian skin, to stay with Asian skin, depending on where you live, in a city, in the countryside, in the north of China, in the south of China, even with the same kind of ethnic origin, your skin condition will be extremely different, your food habits, your level of stress. So again, it's yeah, you are right. Personalization is a great tool to adapt, but on the ground, not in a generic way.
But do you find that your growth opportunities in Asia are very distinct than North America or even Europe?
Yeah, I mean, honestly, when you look at the beauty industry today, most of the growth is fueled by China. Okay, that's a fact. I mean, look at all the performance of the cosmetic beauty brands. Most of it is coming from China. So yes, there is today a huge focus in Asia, generally speaking, but more specifically on China. That's for sure. Not saying that there are not growth opportunities in other parts of the world, but China is the big focus these days.